Welcome back to TV 38. This is WADL, and you're watching Detroit Wants to Know. One of those issues Mayor Bing has to take care of once he gets rid of the City Hall fiasco, gets the budget together, is the fiasco at the crime lab. Let me tell you, in 2008, Kenneth Cockrell, the mayor at the time, remember that when he was mayor and not fifth down or fourth down in the city council? He was mayor. He actually closed the crime lab because of the fact evidence was messed up and the prosecutor was very upset with it. Today, I have one of my initial guests on Detroit Wants to Know, super criminal attorney, Ray Anthony Paige, who's going to break it down. Ray Paige, welcome back.
It's good to be back, Steve.
Listen, glad you're alive.
Listen, I'm glad to be alive. I'm glad to be seen and not viewed, you know?
Yes.
Let's talk about this thing. The crime lab is one of the most egregious things that's happened in the history of this city, in that it was a situation in which what you think is these quasi-professional people that are supposed to come into court and testifying to the validity of ballistics and things of that nature. What we found out is that the crime lab was an abomination of pollution, disorderly staff, corruption. And it was at the behest, I believe, of the Wayne County prosecutor and not the mayor himself, who said that this should not happen, and they cut it down. Now, what does this mean to Joe Doe citizen out
there? Yeah, I mean, are they wrongly accused?
They're wrongly accused. I mean, there's some people that are in prison right now, probably in prison for contaminated, compromised evidence. Now, it doesn't mean much to a person that's in their kitchen right now trying to cook breakfast if they don't have a loved one that's incarcerated. But for those folks that have people incarcerated in the state prison system and you believe that their evidence might have been contaminated or compromised, how bad can it get? You know, I believe that one out of every four prisoners is falsely accused and falsely housed.
One out of four.
One out of four. I believe that compromised evidence, embellished evidence, incompetent lawyers, and an overzealous jury system that is out there to convict and not to acquit. And because of that, I believe that people don't get their fair shake in our criminal justice system. You know,
will people then be able to appeal?
Yeah, well, they have a clearinghouse going on right now is that if someone's in jail right now or been convicted, and even if you didn't go to prison but you were convicted based on some evidence that came out of that crime lab, you can petition to the Wayne County Prosecutor's Office. You can call 224-5777.
That's 224-5777.
Area code 313. And you can say, listen, will you put me in contact with the person who's in charge of the crime lab fiasco? And there's a person over there, and they will put you in contact with this person, and then you can write a letter to this person, or you can go in personally and see them, and they will reopen the case and retest the evidence.
You'll retest the evidence.
Right. I have about five cases pending right now, Steve, in which they have agreed to retest the evidence.
Now, you hardly ever lose, so that's like a minuscule percentage, though.
Well,
so you
listen,
might that win-loss record might go up.
Well, it will go up. I'm suggesting that I believe that in two of the cases, the evidence was compromised. Now, no one is perfect. And even on certain days, the most perfected of us, you know, are subject to things that that we don't have any control over. Now, how in the world would I have known that the police officers and people, civilian personnel in the crime lab were hiding evidence or mispackaging things, misclassifying things? It's just one of the things, again, as I started off saying, it's an abomination and it shouldn't happen.
But even though it was closed in 2008, it wasn't until May of 2011 the Free Press actually went by and found that it was open, and they had fax machines and they had rape kits, all this stuff still out there. When we come back, I want to talk about it real quick. What's the phone number where the wrongly accused can get in touch with you?
We can dial me at RAPLAW1, RAPLAW2, that's 313-496-7271,
496-7272. 496-7271. 496-7271 or 496-7272.
RAPLAW1 and RAPLAW2.
And RAPLAW2. When we come back, we're going to talk to Ray Page about a couple other issues facing the city of Detroit, because he's out there, he's on the front lines. This is Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching TV 38 WADL. We'll be right back. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. This is TV 38 WADL, and I'm with super criminal attorney Ray Page. Ray Page, did you have any more comments on the crime lab? Because I want to ask you another question.
Well, you know, it's been said, you know, and again, that number's out there for anyone that feel like they've been wronged or there's something didn't happen in a criminal case. They should call the prosecutor's office, and if you can't get to the prosecutor's office, call my office. We have dedicated ourselves to represent the falsely accused and the falsely convicted.
That's Rap Law 1 and Rap Law 2 to get to your office. Next question, you're on the front lines. Earlier this week, two young ladies are found with their heads blown off in Detroit. We've got shootings and killings going across all of the city. Is it getting better or worse? You're out here defending the wrongly accused in these matters. Is it getting better or worse, Ray?
It's getting worse because, you know, it's reflective of what's happening in our society. Less jobs, less educated people. People are disillusioned. There's no respect for young people, no respect for the elderly. You're seeing horrifying crimes. People are, this generation that came up on these video games, they believe that this stuff is, you know, not real. They believe that they can go into the house and kill everybody, and then the next day they can play the game over with. But, you know, death is a finite thing, and these kids grow up thinking that this stuff that they see in the imagery of their PlayStations and the Xboxes and things of that nature, they get confused about the circumstance of what death is really is. And so you see these most horrifying crimes, I believe, is reflective, one, of how these kids have come up, not understanding that this is reality versus, you know, this a game. And other things, they're not in church. They're not in church. They're not over at your brother's church or in churches in which they're getting that spiritual influx to letting them know that, hey, listen, there's a higher being than car being that you're carrying. You know, that car being is not your God. There's a real God and there's a real spirit, and I believe that because there's a lack of that in the community, we're seeing horrifying crime, Steve.
Ray, it's interesting you should say that they should get back into church, they should get some moral fiber, moral belief. I think it's getting worse also. I think Detroit, there are pockets where it's getting nicer because they're protected pockets, but there are pockets where it's just left fallow and it's a full battleground. I don't know how we turn it around. In the first segment, we talked about the EAS, the Educational Achievement System. All right, we talked about this thing, but I don't know how you fix that, how you make that work without making the parents work, without uplifting the parents. Bad parents breed bad kids, breed bad parents. Somewhere it has to stop. How do you think we stop it?
Well, you know, I had a guy say to me, and I thought it was very horrible the way he put it. He said, if you want to, if you follow dumb children's home, you're going to find dumb parents. And, you know, I said, man, that's a cruel thing to say, but it's a reality. And, here's the thing. You know, a lot of the parents, or whether it's a single parent household or both parents are there, they're overly taxed. You know, they're uneducated, if you don't know, you don't know. So what we got to do is collectively, it takes a village to raise these kids, and those that are stakeholders in this city, notwithstanding whether that's your blood running in John and Jane's veins, we must engage in help raising them, you know, and I think that's what it's going to take. If we stop giving lip service to it and start giving a real work product to it and putting some pedal to the metal, we can do some things. You're out there on the front line. I'm out there on the front line. We need the community to be out there on the front lines and engage in saving this city and saving this state.
Well, one of the things I believe in terms of saving the city and saving the state, we need to bring back the simple things. When we come back, I hope you'll at least stay in the studio during this interview. I'm going to introduce you to a brand new ice cream store in downtown Detroit, in the Eastern Market. And it's so beautiful. You can sit on the benches and eat your ice cream on a Sunday night, just like on a Saturday night, Friday night, just like the old days used to be. Because it's in the Eastern Market, it's secure. You don't have to worry about anything. And you know what's even best? It was built by a multi-generational black female family. Amazing. You need to stay and watch that, Ray. Remember, if you're wrongly accused, Rap Law 1 or Rap Law 2, it'll get you to the super attorney, Ray Page. This is Steve Hood. This is Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching WADL. We'll be right back.